Welcome back to Vegas Live with Nina. I'm Nina, I'm your host, and you know where I am. I'm on the red couch, number one, which is mine. And I'm also at the Peppermill Lounge in Las Vegas. So we're filming out of Las Vegas. I have Rude Mike with me, and I have Rude Mama with me. Now, this is the mother of Mike. Now, yes. To me, they look like brother and sister. Amazing looking woman. I can't believe. So she says, everybody tells me the same thing. She said, I must have had him very young. Well, you were 18 when you
had
him.
I was 18 when I had
him. Yes, yes.
I was.
So, yes.
I felt that I was too young, but, you know.
Well, no, but look at him now. Now you can be brother and sister.
Yeah. It's working. It works.
Yeah. Now, it's only a couple of days since I've seen you.
Yes.
You have a fabulous a radio show, a television show, because you film it. Mm-hmm. It's also radio, mm-hmm. 702.5 FM.
Yes.
Did I get that right?
Yes, 702.5
FM. It's hot. It's always hot.
Yep.
And they have a fabulous studio, and I was just down there, and he was asking me all sorts of lovely questions, and I hope I answered them well.
You did. I loved your answers. Your answers were amazing.
Were they okay?
They were amazing. They were amazing.
It was great.
And it's not real pre-rehearsed, because I don't pre-rehearse anything. No. I don't pre-interview anything. So what's up? So, Mike, what are you up to?
Why? Because you gave me such a wonderful interview, so we had to come
back. So now we're going to come back and find out what's going on.
Yes, and let you know that interview, every time you come, is amazing.
Oh,
and the feedback we got, because the questions we asked were questions that our listeners were wanting to know.
Well, you were prepared.
Yes, I was more I was
more prepared this time, because I think you realized, because the first one we did, it was... Because I interview, I kind of was interviewing you,
which I liked. So this
which
time,
was good too.
I interviewed you,
but this time he interviewed me, which was really that was the whole purpose of the whole thing, so we can get the message out there.
Yes.
And of course, Mama was on with us as well.
Yes.
And what did you think of it? Did you like it?
I did. I really enjoyed it. We got a lot of feedback from it, and a lot of people wanted to know because I announced that we had a special guest coming in Friday, and. Our phones have been buzzing because everyone wants to know
who's coming in.
Is.
And who is he anyway?
Well, I'm not giving it away yet. You have to stay tuned.
The
Friday,
secret is
5
still
to
a secret.
At Hot 702.5. And
it's that.
Rude Mike doesn't even know who it is.
Rude Mike doesn't know yet.
Oh. I'm sorry. I can't do like you do and have a guest come on and don't know. I have to know every guest that comes on the show.
No, I don't. I love the intrigue of. I mean, the first thing I'm asked them, the people, because I know you.
Mm-hmm.
So. Is what do you do? That's my first question. What do you do? So I can go from there, not in the business, whatever business they're in doesn't really make any difference to me, because I can go from that. And that's only because I've been interviewing for so many years.
Well, I'm trying to get there. This is my teacher. This is my mentor. So I'm working to get
mentor.
There. And, like, I mean, so it has me just
so
rocking my
brain.
So
how do you like your radio show so far? Because you're in a pretty good station. You're doing very well.
I'm in an amazing station. And we're doing from where we've been to where we are now. I love the growth.
You love the growth.
I love the growth.
Yeah.
I love the growth. And for what's coming next.
Because you kind of
so
started
blessed.
This, you were watching my show, actually in hospital or something.
Yes, I had back surgery and I
love
was
my
watching
show
your show.
That's what I want to do.
And that, watching your show, I knew that I wanted to do, I wasn't for sure exactly, but I know I wanted to do something in the same line of what you were doing. So once I got the chance to set out, I started doing stand-up comedy and it was fun, it was cool, but it wasn't what I wanted
your
to do.
Your heart wasn't in it?
No.
So your heart is now in what you do.
I love, this is my bread and butter. This is my day in and day out at radio. I love radio. This is my dream job.
So what do you think of your son doing this? Because I know you've got your back behind him. Obviously, you always have done.
Well, when he...
Is he good? Is he okay?
I didn't get into it. I didn't get into the radio with Mike until he had the back surgery. And I had to fill in for him. And I kind of panicked because I had never done anything like that before.
You got to do this for your son.
Yeah, so I got there and he kept calling me and telling me, you got it, you can do it. And I did it and it was so amazing. I loved it.
I think people get a little bit nervous. They see the camera because that's your friend.
Right.
When you speak into this little round thing, it's right there. And then we have the microphones all over the place. Mm-hmm. We've got microphones, so we pick up everything that goes on. I think people get more nervous by seeing all this around them than the actual doing the talking.
Yeah, exactly.
The talking is quite easy, actually.
Yes. Once you get into it and you just start going like with us when you come in, once we go live, it just flows. It's so easy.
Yeah, it just sort of goes on. And it is. It becomes very easy. But not for everybody.
Not for everybody, because we've had some interviews and it felt like we were at a dentist office pulling teeth. But, you know, we get through it. You push through those interviews. And, again, I learned that from you on how to go through it without actually calling people out.
Yeah, like, you kind of listen to them and you listen to when they talk about something. But the greatest thing about a talk show, whether it's live or not live or it's radio or whatever it is to listen to your guest.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Because once you listen to your guest, then you can pick things out of what they're saying and what they're doing. So it becomes quite easy. But it's not a thing for everybody.
Right. No, we've come to see that and we've found that out. But we've worked it till I feel that we're getting there. We're doing, I feel we're on an amazing ship. And we're going
I think laughing and sort of being friendly with your guests is probably going to bring everything out. And that sort of, you know, helps.
Yes.
Rather than concentrating on what you're trying to do and they're nervous, that kind of brings in that little...
That's why we try to break the ice.
I think we make everyone comfortable.
We've got to make them feel comfortable so they forget. Let them forget they're on the radio or on television.
Right.
And once you let them forget... Mm-hmm. Then they hopefully can do it.
Yeah, and I can tell everybody once, we want you to sit down. When you come and do an interview with us and you're sitting down, we want you to feel it's an actual just sit down conversation. It's not a radio interview. It's a
conversation. That's why I call mine is a coffee table conversation. That's what I call it. I'm like at the coffee table having a lovely conversation with the two. And that's what we're doing right now. We're having a great conversation. It's just being recorded. I hope it's good. Hey, Steve, is it good?
Oh, we're doing good.
What is your next move now? You've got this far. You're doing extremely well. You've got something in mind?
Yes, we are.
What?
We are in the midst of setting up a new show. Another show.
What sort of show? Don't tell me you can't talk about it.
A reality show.
A reality show. Come on, Mama, you tell me. He doesn't want to tell me what it is. He's afraid someone's going to steal it. It doesn't matter if they steal it, they'll never make it like you make it.
True.
Never worry about people stealing your stuff. People say to me, Nina, they're coming down to watch your show so they can steal stuff from me. They can just watch me on YouTube, but they can't. I always say they can't take this voice.
They can't take your voice.
They can't take any of that. And there's thousands of people out there doing talk shows on radio and television. So don't worry about it.
Right.
Well then,
you're just another one.
We're in the middle of doing a reality show.
A reality show on whom or what?
It's going to be based off the radio. It's based off of us in Vegas.
Okay.
It's a Vegas-based reality show.
Vegas
showing
of what you're doing.
I was born and raised here. So we're going to show my insight of what Vegas
was, what it was, and what it really is.
Because people consider Vegas, is gambling, drinking. Vegas is more than that. They don't see what's behind the scenes.
I definitely agree with you on that, but Vegas was built on gambling.
They think that that's all Vegas is. And that's not, we want to show that
I'm not sure, quote unquote, I'm going to ask Steve, I believe this is the highest grossing place probably in the world with visitors.
It is.
I don't know because I don't read statistics and I don't do all that stuff, but I'm going to go on guesswork on every single weekend, forget when they've got a basketball thing going on or whether they've got a skating thing going on or whether
they've got football going on.
I don't care what they've got going on. It's busy every single weekend. You can't get in, you can't get out.
We want to show the other things other than just...
But the gambling, and I agree actually that Vegas has changed regarding gambling,
mm-hmm.
because there's other things to do now with the stadium.
Right.
You've got this new stadium being built.
Mm-hmm.
You've got a lot of stuff coming into the place. You've got, I think it's the, I shouldn't mention the hotel, but I'm going to mention it. The South Point has a lot of rodeo shows going on. And that's different. They've got their own rodeo ring underneath the hotel,
mm-hmm.
or beside the hotel. I don't know where exactly it is. I think it's on the first. Wherever it is, they've got that happening. So they've got a lot of stuff going on in Vegas, but it still is a gambling place.
Yes, right. Well, we're not knocking the gambling. We want to show that you can come and gamble, but it's families here too. There's things here to do other than just that.
Well, I think there's more families moving in. I just had a real estate guy, Eric, on the show. He's telling me how many people are coming into the town. You can still buy a beautiful home here for $300,000.
Yes, yes. Oh, yes.
You tell me where else, and that you want to live in some place where it's really cold and miserable in the country. But even then, that's expensive. I don't
even
know
more than this.
But yeah. But the housing is coming up, right?
Yes.
It's sort of more expensive than it used to be.
Yes,
obviously.
It is, and that has a lot to do with the fires and the weather and stuff that we have around the country.
Yes.
And the people are being misplaced and don't have homes and stuff, so
they
a lot of them.
And the weather has
here.
A little better. It's like we've had a few days of rain, and
right.
Mind you, it dropped down to 23 yesterday, I think it was, and we're like, oh, we're so cold. Well, I can remember it was below 23
oh,
in
yes.
back east somewhere.
Oh, yes,
exactly.
So, I've been there for a couple of days.
But then Las Vegas is such a different place.
And that's what we want to show.
And that's what you want to show. So your reality show is the other side. You know, when they were building the dam here, I don't know if you know this, but you know how they have these hats, these hard hats?
Uh-huh.
They were invented when they made the dam. There was a guy had a cap. my little story. He had a just a regular cap on. He dipped it in this kerosene, you know?
Mm-hmm.
And when he took it out, and he said, it went hard. Because that's what kerosene does, it goes hard. So then he put it back on his head. And he realized that he's now made this cut. So then he got another hat, put it on top, and really made the thing, and then that's how it started. And this
wow.
is just quote-unquote, so don't anybody quote, Nina, you made a mistake, and it wasn't like that at all, but that's what I read. So whether it was the first one or the last one, I don't know. But so those are stories that you can sort of, you know, you go back into, like Howard Hughes had many a story, and
mm-hmm.
when the mob came here, and all the different things that happened. I mean, you see the big difference.
Yes. From...
When you were born?
When I was born here, and to what it is today is humongous change. We didn't have the buildings.
Do you like it now or you like it then?
Actually, I like it now.
Isn't that
because it was desert. It was all desert.
Yeah, there was nobody here. I remember you could fly in the plane and you could actually see what it was.
Yeah, it was desert. It was only desert.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And the dirt roads. But now we got roads and we got streets and homes and it's beautiful now.
The last 32 years Vegas has been set.
My time. It's been your time.
Yes.
You're 32 years
yes.
old. And you're eligible, aren't you? Oh, you told me you had a girlfriend. Has she fallen through the cracks?
Yes, I'm back single again. you know.
She moved in. He didn't like something. No, she moved in. There's something to do with the children, which, you know, I
yes.
had six stepchildren, by the way.
Well, see, I have a strict rule. If we can't, my kids have a problem, or you don't get along with the kids, you
then
have to
out.
Go because I'm out.
So
never.
You actually, Tony was telling me the story. She was living with him, and he, mm-hmm. she actually didn't like, the kids didn't get on with her or something.
Mm-hmm.
Anyway, so he went out, rented her apartment, I said, move in there.
Yeah.
Look at this.
Did you approve
of her? No, I did not.
Did you approve of what he did?
Yes, I did.
Yes.
And that was because the granddaughter, she had a problem with the granddaughter. She said that he spent too much time. Well, he's a single dad. So he has to spend time with her.
Of course.
So
you do what you want to do. If somebody comes and interferes with it, you shouldn't do it.
Right. Exactly.
So all this will probably come into the reality show,
yes.
won't it?
Yes.
Have you started it or is it?
No, it's written and we're in the middle of talking with a network at the moment. We're in the middle of talking, I can't say, with Netflix and Amazon at the moment.
Okay.
And if it goes through,
great.
We should be shooting by April.
I love it. I love
yes.
it. Maybe we can get Vegas Live with Nina on Netflix.
Of course. I would know
can
that.
You
would
help?
Be beautiful.
Can you help?
I will talk with them. I'll give a conversation about that.
So maybe
yes.
we could get Vegas Live on Netflix and everybody can see
this crazy
woman from England, from Torquay, England, ending up in Las Vegas with a talk show and talking to people she doesn't know. But I do know you too.
Yes.
Yes.
And we love that.
I know. I love that. I love you coming on the show.
I love this woman's accent, and her soul is so beautiful. People, just wanted to put that out there.
Thank you. How can they reach you?
You can always go on Facebook to Rude Mike Young King. You can go to Rude Ma Price, or you could go to Hot 702.5 FM on Facebook, Instagram, and contact us from there.
In other words, Rude Mike can be reached out there. So just remember Rude Mike. That's all you have to know. And just put it in Google or wherever and it comes up.
Yes.
Wonderful. Mama, you look absolutely amazing. I mean, I want to look like that when I get her age.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
I've got a funny feeling I'm older.
Oh,
well, that's okay. We'll be right back. Vegas Life with Nina.